with the start of the game. We should have that ball fly any moment. The Bulldogs look like they are lined up, and they do have 8 players back on the field. So they will only be down 1 player, but the Packers do like to run the ball, and it will be very interesting to see how the Packers run the ball down 1 player, if they decide to pass it and take out a lineman, or if they... Because they usually run in the 2 running back set with the quarterback and shotgun. But with a player down...
I wouldn't take out a lineman. I'd probably take out a receiver, not a lineman. Unless they use a tight end. They use a tight end formation. Right now we're just waiting for the Packers to set up. It looks like they're bringing someone in. We're just waiting for them to set up.
Unless Flo usually likes to go over the rules before he starts each game. He usually likes to tell, you know, no illegal mic ups. If you do have to come back to the field, you know, don't TP into the field, TP somewhere else, and then you will be teleported. If you fly, you'll be immediately ejected and banned from the game. You know,
Okay, while he does that, we'll go a quick word with our sponsor. Come on over to Caps, located on the field of CFL Seahawks. Cover up that ball spot with style at a hat store for everyone. Not just sports hat, no lids, just caps. They have an array of NFL, CFL, and custom caps. Want to support your CFL team or get a funny cap with Caps? Hit up Cameron Cora or Troy Bree Air to get a custom order. I always mess up. It's Troy Bree to get a custom order. I always mess up his name. And it looks like the Packers are going to have Houseman in the middle deep, and they're going to have Hastings. Hastings looks like he's going to set up to his right, to his left, and Santana's going to be on his right.
And there goes the ball, ladies and gentlemen. That is the start of the game, and it is going to be a touchback.
It's going to be Packers ball on the 1st and 10 on the 20-yard line, on their own 20. It looks like Houseman is going to be the QB for them today.
Mm-hmm.
And it looks like they're not going to play with the running back.
No, that's very odd to see. I guess maybe they plan their... I guess they're going to do what the Yellow Jackets do when we don't have a running back. Cash will either pass or throw it himself. So that's a great, you know, because that quarterback, you know, you don't know if he's going to run or throw it, and it can be... But we do have a dead ball.
They call the dead ball. It's probably going to be an offsides on the offense. Let's see what the officials call.
Usually Flo has it out here sooner. Packers must be arguing.
It's going to be an offsides on the offense. It's definitely. It's going to be 5 yards, and first down is going to be repeated.
That's going to bring.
It's an offside.
Yep. First and 15 on the 15.
Right, on the 15, yeah. So Houseman's going to set up again as QB, and it looked like he was trying to run it right till they called the ball dead.
But you are going to see that a lot from the Packers, is that run game.
Okay, they're sitting with the 2 tight ends. They've got Devanter on the right and Durant on his left side as tight ends. As receiving, he's got Hastings on the right and Santana's going to be on the far left of him.
I will see. I'm going to guess you're going to see most of those tight ends used tonight as additional blockers. Because that's how the Packers like to... But he does get stumbled in the backfield. He did get clear. He does break the line of scrimmage. He is going to pick up 10 yards. That will bring up 2nd and 5. It's very, very bad news for the Bulldogs to stumble him behind the line of scrimmage. But him to break free like that and pick up 10 yards is a great run.
Yeah, you got, it's going to be on the Packers 25. Yeah, he did. That was an excellent run to the left. Even though he did get stumbled, he continued going. He's going to set up again with the same formation.
Oh,
he's
he does.
Break
yep.
To the left.
Break to the left.
Run it to the left.
And he picks up 3. Yep, 2 yards for 3rd and
picks
3.
Up 2 yards. It's going to be 3rd and 3 on their own 27. Yeah. Let's see, maybe he'll run it to the right this time.
I'm surprised that player doesn't have a helmet on.
Yeah.
He does get stumbled at the line of scrimmage, and the Bulldogs do get him after that stumble.
Yeah, it's going to be no gain on the play. It's going to be 4th and 3rd on their 27. I see if they'll punt it away at this point. They're too deep in their own territory to give it back to them now.
I'm going to guess punt, but you never know. There are some teams in the CFL who just love to go for it, which I enjoy watching. Like when the Jets are like 4th and 20 and they go for it, I root for those guys to make that play happen. But it looks like they are going to punt.
Yeah, but it's too early in the game to really gamble like that. I mean, it's still zip-zip, and it's still got about 6:58 left in the quarter, so there's plenty of time to do that. I don't think they need to turn the ball over so deep in their end zone. I mean, in their territory at this point. All right, they're going to have Red Star deep. The Dogs are. To recover.
And the ball is
kick it
going
to the left.
That is a great kick from that Packers player. That was a I don't know the exact yardage, but it was a very far punt. That was
a nice kick.
Yes.
Kick that to about the 19. The Bulldogs are going to take possession on their own 19. It's going to be 1st and 10 for them.
They're at their 9 actually.
Correction. It's going to be it's going to be on their 9. I'm sorry. Correction. It's going to be on the Bulldogs' 9. It is an excellent. All right, Eric is going to set up in the back. He's going to have Red Star to his right. He's got 2 receivers to the left. He's got Quicksand and Zaney to the right. And he's got Sky Tower, and I didn't catch the other guy's name.
What is
and
going
is gonna run it
to be a
right.
run play? He does wait for his couple of blocks before he does cross the line of scrimmage, which did block that, yes.
About 4 yards. Yeah, it picks up about 4 yards on the play. So it's going to be 2nd and 6 on their own 13.
Timeout.
It's going to be a timeout call
from
the Packers. Packers call a timeout. Yeah.
Maybe they want to bring in a 9th player. I'm going to guess that that's what is going to happen. They are going to TP in a 9th player.
Yeah, they probably are.
Yep, that's exactly what they're doing.
That's exactly what they're going to do, yeah.
But while we wait, let's get out another ad for tonight.
Okay. The IT girls and fellas are a professional dance team. They do everything from dance shows to flash mob proposals for weddings and charities. If anyone is interested in this group, please contact Windsong Charming or Carabella Valise. Yeah, the Packers are going to bring in someone.
So that is good for them to get that 9th player and make this game even on teams. But they have to hope that none of their players crash in the middle of a game. But that player is clear to play. That skull is green on the script checker and height checker. So he will be out here on the field before the next play starts.
Here he comes out onto the field. Okay, it's going to be, there's about 6:21 left in the first quarter. And they brought in, was it Loon they brought in, I think it was? Yeah, it's Loon.
Yes, it is. It is Loon.
In.
And it looks like the Packers are going to use the 4-2-1 defense against the Bulldogs.
Eric is going to set up in the back. He's got Lockwood is going to play off. Oh, correction. Lockwood is going to go to the line. He's going to have quick Cheesy and Lockwood off to his right. On his left, he's going to have Holiday, and Sky Tower is going to be just on the inside of him.
One of the...
Looks like the Bulldogs is down.
Yeah. They should bring in that player. Bring in one of their extra players on the bench over there to fill up that ninth slot, but we will see what happens. Play clock has not started yet, so it should be...
It's just started now.
Oh, and there we go. Looks like they are not going to wait for a ninth player. He does get the ball out before he is sacked. Makes a great throw to Irish Sky Tower. Irish Sky Tower does have lots of room. He is going to score the touchdown. There is no Packers anywhere near him. That is going to be a touchdown. That is a great throw by Sire to Irish.
It's going to be an 87-yard touchdown.
Great throw. Irish Sky Tower did burn. That's the issue with the 4-2-1, is you really only have one safety. So you really do need those linebackers to come back and help with coverage. But I feel like Irish Sky Tower did burn that linebacker right when the play started. So it's very good to get the Bulldogs to take advantage of that kind of defense and use it for the touchdown.
Lockwood setting up for the extra point. And the extra point is up. And it's good. It's going to make it 7, Bulldogs 7, and the Packers 0 at this point. That was an excellent pass. That was an excellent pass. Excellent run by Sky Tower also.
Exactly. Very great play.
That was an excellent run by him, too. So the Bulldogs come out on their first possession and score against the Packers. And the Packers are going to set up again. They're going to have Hausman deep, and to his right is Santana, and to his left is going to be Hastings deep with him.
The Bulldogs keep losing players. It's very, very odd. Oh, they do bring it. They are TPing. Yeah. They are TPing in a player at the moment.
Yeah, actually, this is the best time to do it when they change the possession of the ball.
Yes.
Possession of the ball is changed. They don't use up a timeout if they do it then.
But let's talk about SoCal, ladies and gentlemen. Check out Southern California, a theme sim dedicated to real-life SoCal beaches. Come relax on the beach, feed some seagulls, take a bite ride along the coast, and soak up some sun with friends. Complete with our typical SoCal swap meet area and the famous Southern Cali sports skateboarding at our local skate park. Stores located in the town's main area for all your shopping needs, including a cape, clothing for dudes with a California feel, lots of photography opportunities with a realistic weather-changing atmosphere, perfect for any blogger. Call it home by renting adorable beachfront apartments with fantastic views, shop, hang out, play, where loitering is encouraged and memories are made. That is SoCal, ladies and gentlemen.
That sounds like an interesting place. I still haven't had the chance to get
there. It's a beautiful sim. I've went there a couple times.
Now it looks like the Dogs are just about ready to kick it. There you go, and the ball's in play.
There goes the kick.
And they're going to kick it off to the left.
And it's going to be...
It's going to take a bounce and roll into the end zone. It's going to be first and 10 on the Packers' own 20.
And it's going to be another touchback. And the Packers are going to go straight back into the power formation.
Yeah, this time they're going to have Loon in the backfield. He's going to set up behind Hausman, and to his left he's got Santana, and Hastings is going to be out to the right as receivers.
But Bulldogs are going to be down a safety. I do not see why they are not grabbing a player.
They got someone coming out now.
Oh,
they
here we go.
Yeah, but here it comes. He's coming out now. There it goes.
ball should be hiked any moment.
They have about 4 seconds left on the ball clock. 2-1.
They are going to get the delay of game. Yep. It is going to be.
That was costly for the Packers.
They do have 60 seconds.
They were set up.
Yeah.
I'm sorry?
They have a full minute to get the play out, and they were set up pretty quickly.
They were set up pretty fast. I don't understand what the delay was, but it's going to cost them 5 yards.
So the Packers, again, get a penalty before their first play of their possession even starts, and makes it difficult for them even before their first hike. But let's see if they can make up from this.
Now the Packers set up again. They got Hastings on the right, and Santana's out to the left. And behind Houseman, they're going to have Loon set up as a lone running back. All right, here we go. The officials put the ball in play now. There's about 5:55 left in the first quarter. He's going to roll to the right. And Houseman is going to look, and he passes it down.
Great catch. Great catch from that Packers player. Great throw. Great catch. That Packers player was...
43 yards on the play.
That Packers player was covered.
Like that was passed to Hastings. That was Hastings that recovered the ball.
That was a great throw. It was right over the defender's head into his player's arm. That was a fantastic throw from that Packers quarterback because he was tightly covered.
Yeah, but Hastings got free on that one and turned it into a 43-yard gain.
Mm-hmm.
So it's going to be 1st and 10 for the Packers on the Dogs' 42-yard line. And Hassan's going to go with the same setup. He's got Hastings to the right. Santana is going to be off to his left. And Loon is going to be in the back. And it's going to be a timeout called by the Packers.
The Packers have called.
That's their second timeout.
Yes, it is. I don't know. I don't know what the problem is. We do have Bulldogs. They did have 9 on the field, but now they are down to 6. Let's hope the Bulldogs can fix this crashing issue with their players before the end of this game, or the Packers will take advantage of that.
There he goes. The Packers are setting up again.
But the good thing about the timeout is both teams have to be ready before they can hike the ball. So I'm going to guess that until the Bulldogs do TP in those crash players, they will not say they are ready for the timeout to end, but we shall see.
Well, actually, it was the Packers that called the timeout.
After the timeout, both teams have to tell the referee that they're ready, or the play does not start. So if the Bulldogs are not ready, but the Packers are, the timeout still happens. It's more or less the Bulldogs are taking advantage of the Packers calling the timeout at the moment.
While we wait for another word from our sponsor, experience the unique atmosphere of Mystic Rose Club with stunning design and decor. This club is open to all. Listen to music and dance on the state-of-the-art floor. For romantic moments, retreat with your partner to the secluded tables on the second floor or visit the bar. Weekend events start out with a live DJ to set the mood, followed by live singers to close out the evening. All right, here we go. Looks like the Dogs are ready again.
And here comes their 9th player off the bench.
There's about 4:55 left in the quarter. And right now it seems the Packers are threatening to score on the Dogs. They're on the Bulldogs' 42-yard line. And Houseman's going to take and roll it to the left.
He does have room.
It looks like he's not going to turn the corner. Yes, he does turn the corner. He picks up roughly about 2 yards. So it's going to be 2nd and 8 on the Dogs' 40-yard line.
Very nice job from that outside linebacker of the Bulldogs to come and follow that quarterback. Because he did come out, but then he ran back in to try to juke him, but the linebacker still stayed there, and eventually it did stop that run. Only 2 yards is, to me, in my opinion, is a very good run stoppage.
He's going to take it, he's going to roll it to the right, and he's going to run it up the middle. He's going to gain roughly about 3 yards. So it's going to be 3rd and 5 on the Bulls 37. And Houseman is gaining some decent yards. The last 2 plays, he's already accumulated 5 yards on 2 runs. So it's going to be 5. It's going to be 3rd and 5 for the Packers now. Let's see what they can do here now.
And there goes the Packers hiking the ball. It is going to be a throw play to that wide open receiver. He is going to break that tackle and stumble away from it, and he is going to score the touchdown. So it is going to be 7 Bulldogs, Packers 6, with only 3 minutes and 25 seconds left of the first quarter. Very nice job from that Packers quarter.
Very nice play.
Yes.
Very nice play.
He noticed that player was wide open on that side, and he did get stumbled, but luckily he did break through.
It was going to be Santana. Santana made the score on that one. And Houseman's going to set up for the extra points. And he kicks it, and it's
the extra
no
point was no
extra
good.
Point.
That is going.
That's gonna cost them.
That is going to hurt the Packers very much, and you know that's why you need someone on your team to practice. You know that kicking. You know, because
yeah,
a clear example would be last night's game with the Titans versus the Warriors. It came down to a field goal, but the Warriors did have a chance to score a field goal at the end of the second quarter,
well,
but they did miss it.
This isn't going to hurt them very much. It's only 1 point. The Dogs are up only by 1 point at this point, at this game, at this juncture. So I mean, it's not really going to hurt them. It's not like they missed a field goal for 3 points. So I still think the Packers are way in it. They're going to kick the ball, and the ball is going to be kicked right up the middle, and it's going to bounce over Lockwood's head into the end zone. It's going to be 1st and 10. For the Dogs on their own 20. But yeah, it's not going to be very costly. I wouldn't, if I was them, I wouldn't sweat it so much.
Well, no, but, point. Yes, but if you do think about it, if they do go back, because they have gone back and forth with touchdowns on both sides, and if this is how this game goes, where it's, you know, both teams score 4 touchdowns together, that 1 point will make the difference at the end of the game.
Yeah, but it's too premature to worry about that because we're still in the first quarter. It's 3:13 left. That's something I think that you'd worry about later on in the game. But right now, it's not going to hurt the Packers. I think right now, just them scoring gives them momentum. So it puts them on an even keel with the Bulldogs at this point, because the Bulldogs came out on their first possession and scored. And on the Packers' second possession, they scored. Granted, they missed the 1 point kick, but that's okay. I wouldn't beat up on the teammate that bad for that one. And it looks like a timeout was called. Well, the play was stopped by the official. Excuse me.
Well, let's go. I'm going to read the next ad while we wait for... We have the Mystic Rose Club, ladies and gentlemen. Experience the unique atmosphere of the Mystic Rose Club. With stunning design and decor, this club is open to all. Listen to music and dance on the state-of-the-art dance floor for romantic moments. Retreat with your partner to the secluded tables on the second floor, or visit the bar. Weekend events start out with a live DJ to set the mood, followed by live singers to close out the evening.
Okay, I've been informed by the official that someone is wearing an invisible skin on the Packers, and I think that's what the officials are looking at now. not sure exactly which player it is. Can it be? Is it Santana? It could be Santana. Let me see here. He may be wearing an alpha layer that's hiding his... Yeah, it's going to be Santana. That's who the officials are talking to now.
Oh, I see. It looks like he has a... Yeah, it looks like he has a mesh
alpha.
On. Yeah, an alpha on, yeah.
An alpha, that
yeah.
Extra alpha that's on. Imagine you've never seen that before.
I'm usually when you most teams meet up before each game, they meet up and, get their uniforms ready and talk about their game plan, and it's very odd that one of his teammates, do not tell him, hey, your arms are completely missing from your body.
Okay, it looks like he left the field.
Yeah, I actually believe Flo might have ejected him, or he did leave the field until the issue was fixed, or he's relogging. He might actually be relogging,
I don't think they would throw him out that quickly.
I think he is, I think he probably is relogging to try and fix the issue. But that will bring the Packers down to 8 players until that player can come back. And the Packers will either have to waste their last time out. Ooh, and the Bulldogs aren't even going to wait for the Packers to get their defense. He's going to hike that ball, and he is going to run it. Only for 2 yards, though. They did take advantage of the Packers' delay, but... They did not take... They should have honestly just rushed out those... Yes.
The offense does not have to wait on the defense.
No, they don't. And I honestly believe...
Once they put that ball in play.
Yes. It would have been a better choice if the Bulldogs decided, with the Packers not paying attention, to send their receivers out deep and just toss the ball out. Because most of their players were near the line to stop the run. So we will see... I don't blame him for taking advantage of it. But he does hand off the ball to... Rhino, and he does lose 3 yards. Rhino got the ball, but he stood there for a moment.
It's going to be 3rd and 11 on the Dogs' own 19. Yeah, I don't know why he stood there for a second. He just stood there for a second. Actually, I was still following Eric there for a moment until I saw Rhino at it. Sets up again. He's going to have Red Star to his right. He's going to have Cheesy and Zaney off to his right as receivers, and he's going to roll it to the left.
He does have lots of room. He does throw the ball.
He just throws it short by about 5 yards.
Yes, he underthrew that ball greatly. He had
Holiday. I think it's Holiday.
Yes, he had Holiday out there.
Short by 5 yards. So it's going to be 4th and 11.
The Bulldogs will be, yes.
Yeah, let's see what they do now. Let's see if they're going to punt it.
Yes, they are. They're set up in the punt formation.
Okay. They're going to have Lopez is going to be deep to recover for the Packers. He's going to be standing roughly at about his own 35.
And there goes the ball. It is going to go out at the 33.
About the 32 and a half?
Yeah.
Roughly? Yeah, it's going to be 1st and 10. Yeah, about 32. You're right. It's about 32-yard line.
Not a great punt, but not a bad punt either. Most teams like to make that ball bounce and then slide down the field.
So the Packers are going to take it. It's going to be 1st and 10 for them on their own 32. Let's see if they threaten to score again. They got about 1:44 left in the quarter. Officials out onto the field now. Do they have a crashed player? Is that what
No, I think the rule is that players, you know, need to. I know it's SL football, but I think the rule is that players need to have a helmet on, and that Packers player hasn't had a helmet on since the start of the game. And I think Flo has told him a couple times already to put a helmet on.
Houseman's going to set up. He's going to have Loon set up as a lone running back. Lopez is still in the game. Oh, there he goes. He's going off to the sideline now. Houseman's going to have Hastings out wide to his right, and on his left is going to be Santana. The two tight ends are going to be Durant on his left, and Devanter is going to be on his right side as tight ends. And he's going to roll it.
It's going to be a dead ball penalty. Another dead ball penalty on the Packers.
Probably going to be an offsides again.
We will see what slow burner. It's going to be another false start.
It's going to be an offsides on the offense. Yeah, it's going to be offsides. This is going to be the third penalty of the game against the Packers. So it's going to be their down is going to be repeated. It's going to be 5 yards deeper back is what they're going to be at. So they're going to be roughly at about their own
28-yard line.
28-yard line. This quarter's taken forever. It's like a minute 43 left in the first quarter.
There has been lots of pauses, and there has been lots of delays. The Packers have called two timeouts. There has been a lot of TPing players in, and there also has been a lot of penalties.
There we go. We have the officials are out on the field now. I guess they're sorting out some sort of problem where the Packers are. Oh, here they go. They're clearing the field now. Houseman's going to set up. He's going to have Loon again. Out to Loon running back. And he's going to roll it to the right. And he's going to cut back in. And he's going to pick up a couple of yards on that one. He's going to pick up roughly about 4 yards on that play. It's going to be 2nd and 11 on the Packers' 31-yard line. Lopez is back out on the field again, this time with the helmet on.
We do have a full nine on the field for the Packers again.
And you're right, Lopez does have a helmet on this time, so I guess he told him to put on the helmet. Alright, there's about 59 seconds left in the first. And Houseman's going to roll to the left.
It's going to be another flag.
To the right.
I'm going to... It is probably going to be a false start on the Packers. Oh, it is. No cadence.
Ah, that's costly. That's going to be roughly the fourth. That's going to be their fourth penalty. Well, the one advantage is that it does stop the clock. The clock was taken away on them for the first quarter. Right, about 57 seconds left. This play will probably end the quarter.
Yes. Well, they are going to line up again. And it is still, I believe it's still 2nd and 15, or let's see what it is. It is.
Yeah, roughly.
They have not announced what it is going to be 2nd and 16. 16. Yes.
And Austin's going to set up in a shotgun formation. He's going to roll to the right.
He does have a lot of players open on the deep right side of that field. That is exactly where he's going to throw it. He is going to... Wow, that is not great coverage from those Bulldogs. That player is just going to run in and score a touchdown.
That's going to be Hastings scoring a 74-yard touchdown. Hastings' second score today. So the Packers are going to lead the Dogs 12-7 at this point. And Houseman is going to set up for the extra point. That was a great run by...
It was more or less the Bulldogs secondary.
By Hastings. It was a great run by Hastings. Great pass.
I don't know how the Bulldogs just left that. If you watch the play, the Packers had four players down the exact same side of the field. And when he threw that ball up, it was up for either of those four players, and there was no Bulldogs around at all.
And the Packers are going to... That field goal is going to be good for them. So it's going to be the Packers leading 13 to the Bulls 7.
I don't know what happened.
There's still about 39 seconds left in the quarter. I didn't think they were going to waste the time, but they didn't.
I don't know what happened.
Like,
Well, if you watch the play, the Bulldogs secondary, their right side quarterback and their right side cornerback and the right side safety just completely left that side of the field open for the Packers. I don't know what happened there, but that's an issue that the Packers might take advantage of all night if it does happen again.
It looks like the Dogs are not going to have anybody deep. They're going to have Eric off to the right, and they're going to have Quicksand off to the left. Correction, Lockwood is going to be deep for them now. About 39 seconds left in the first quarter. And the Packers are ready, just about ready to kick it to them.
And there goes the kick. It is going... It is a touchback. Zaney was there to catch it, but it seems like he misjudged it by a little bit. And the Bulldogs will start at their own 20-yard line.
Is going to set up. He's going to have Red Star, the lone running back, off to his right.
He's going to hand the ball off. He does have a lot of room. He does pick up 6 yards.
That was 6 yards on the play.
Great run play from the Bulldogs. Their line did do a great job to make a hole for Rhino.
He's going to set up with two running backs. He's got Lockwood off to his left, and he's got Red Star to his right. And that's going to end the first quarter.
It is going to be a handoff to Zaney.
Lockwood, yeah.
Zaney does miss that player, but he does get stumbled at the line, and he does lose about 2 yards. Great play from that Packers player to get penetration like that on the Bulldogs line.
6 on the Bulldogs 24-yard line. Eric is going to set up again. He's going to have a lone running back off to his right. He's going to have Red Star back there with him. Hightower and Holiday is going to be off to his left. And to his right, he's going to have Lockwood on the inside, and Quicksand will be, Cheesy will be on the outside of him. Looks like they're going to switch. No, they're not.
And the Bulldogs do hike off the ball. It looks like it is going to be a pass play. He does throw that ball deep to Cheese. It is intercepted from the Packers. The Packers do intercept that pass, and they do have it on the Packers 48. So we will have first and 10 on the 48-yard line with 7:45 left in the second quarter. Let's see what the Packers decide to do here.
I wouldn't be surprised if they marched it down the field. We got Houseman set up. He's got Loon as the lone running back behind him. He's got Santana off to the left, and Hastings is going to be off to his right. Let's see what he does. He's going to roll to the right.
It is going to be a run play. And he does
cuts back in and picks up about 4 yards. It's going to be second and 6 on the Dogs 48-yard line.
It is going to be a dead ball penalty again from the Packers.
It's going to be drifting. That's such a, in my opinion, that's such a silly call. But it's a penalty. That's going to be the Packers' fifth one today.
I am recording the game at the moment, so if the Packers would like to see each of their penalties, they always can go back to the film and see, you know, what went wrong and, you know, who caused the false start and those kind of issues. But we are going to have 2nd and 9, I believe.
It's going to be 2nd and 6. 2nd and 6 on the Packers 48.
Oh, no, but it brings it back 5 yards. They haven't announced the down or the yards yet.
Okay.
But it's 2nd and 11 at the current moment.
So it's going to be 11. Yeah, it's going to be 11 then, yeah. All right, Houseman sets up in the shotgun formation. He's got Loon off to his right, and Devanter's going to be to his left in the backfield. Hastings is going to be the lone receiver to his left, and Durant and Santana is going to be off to his right.
Dead ball penalty again on the Packers. The issue I'm seeing is the Packers line likes to move left or right with their quarterback, and when the quarterback is doing his cadence, it looks like one of their guards keeps moving before the cadence is over.
It's going to be another 5-yard penalty for the Packers. So it's going to be 2nd down and what is it, about 16 yards or something?
It will be 2nd and 16. They started from their 48, but now they are all the way back to their 42.
Eric is going to set up again with 2 running backs. Devanter's going to be to his left, and Loon's going to be off to his right in the shotgun formation. He's going to have 2 receivers off to his right. It's good. Durant and Santana's going to be off to his right.
He does hike the ball.
To the right.
He does throw that ball left to that open Packers player. He does get tackled, but that player did.
Devanter caught the ball. Picks up about 29 yards on the play. So that's going to put the ball on the Bulls 20. I was thinking Chicago Bulls. On the Bulldogs 29-yard line. It's going to be 1st and 10 for the Packers.
They are going to go back to their usual formation, the 2 running back set.
Guys, again, he's going to set up with 2 receivers, Santana, and Javan's going to be off to his right, and he's going to roll it to
the
right.
He is going to run the ball. He's going to run
And he looks like he's got room to run, and he picks up about 18 yards on that play. So the Bulls are going to be marked down on the Bills 11. It's going to be first and 10 for the Packers. It looks like the Packers are starting to threaten to score again. And this time they go with the two tight end setup. And he's got Loon as a lone running back.
Ooh, great penetration from that Bulldog. Oh, he does get stumbled. He is going to get sacked for a loss of 1 yard by two Zaney for you. Great stop from Zaney. He did stumble him, but that Packers player did break out of it. But the Bulldogs came and did help him and stop him from breaking that line of scrimmage. Great job from the Bulldogs to stop that.
It's going to be second and 11 on the Dogs 12. Again, Haskins sets up with the lone running back. Behind him is going to be Loon. And it looks like they're rolling it to the right.
Great, great run.
Haskins looks like he's going to score. He's going to score easily on that. It's a 12-yard run on that one. So that's going to put another 6 points. So it's going to be the Packers 19 and the Dogs 7. That was an excellent run. He had a few blockers in front of him.
It is the Packers have switched their formation up from that power, and it has freed up that run because with that extra receiver, it has brought back one of their linebackers to not blitz straight in. He is going back for coverage, so
Austin sets up, and the point is going to be good. So the Packers are going to lead this game. It's going to be 20 and the Dogs 7. There's about 4:58 left before the half. And again, the Dogs are going to set up with Lockwood playing deep. And to his right is going to be Eric. And to his left is going to be Cheese Quicksand. Also deep for them. There it goes. The ball's in play now.
And there goes the kick.
It's going to be kicked off to the right side of the field.
Two Zaney does pick up the ball. He does have a great hold to the right, but he does get stopped before he does break away. Great tackle by Vince Amore to stop Zaney. He did have a lot of green after that cut, but that player did come in and tackle him. So it'll be first and
18. It's going to be picked up about 18 yards of the play.
It'll be first and 10 from the Packers' 27-yard line.
It's going to be the Bulldogs' 27.
Yeah, I thought it was wherever you're touched, like, since the Bulldogs are running towards the other end. Their side
Well, the 50-yard line, anywhere from the 50-yard line back to where the Bulldogs are playing, is considered their territory. They enter the Packers' territory once they exceed the 50-yard line. So basically, it's going to be second and 11 on their own 27, on the Bulldogs' 27-yard line. He's going to set up with no running back. He's got three receivers off to his left. He's got Holiday, Sky Tower, and Red Star is going to be the third one back there off to his left.
He does get rid of that ball. Interception again by the Packers. Intercepted. And he is going to be stopped at his 19-yard line. So it's going to be first and 10 at the 19-yard line for the Packers. And the play clock. The play clock has been paused. Flow Burner is out on the field. I don't know what the decision is here, but we should have that at any moment.
Osmond's going to set up, and he's going to have Loon off to his right in the backfield. He's got Hastings and Devanter off to his right, and to his left, his receivers, is going to be Santana on the outside and Devant. And it's going to be handed off to Loon.
He is going to gain 5 yards, and Zaney does stop him.
And it's going to be 2nd and 5 on the Bulldogs 15. Councilman's going to set up. He's going to have Loon off to his right, the lone running back. And he's going to roll it to the left. It looks like he's got a blocker or two in front of him, and he's going to cut back, and he's going to make it.
He does get
close,
that first down, though.
He's not going to score. He's going to come close. He picks up about 6 yards. That's going to be close. It's going to be like 1st and inches.
But
it's going to be 1st and 10. I'm sorry, he did make the first time.
Yes,
first
he did.
1st and 10 on the Bulldogs' 9-yard line. I didn't think he made the first down. I thought he was short there.
The Packers are back in their power formation from earlier. Let's see what they decide to do with this. Now, this is where it gets tricky for offenses in this red zone. Looks like it's going to be a pass play. He does have players open at the end zone. Deep in the end zone, they are open. He does toss that ball in the middle. He does catch it for another touchdown. So that is going to be
Santana again for a score.
So it is going to be
9 yard pass touchdown.
7 and 26 at the moment, folks. Well, we will see if the Packers do make this kick, and then it will be 27-7 if they do succeed.
And the extra point, it's good. It's going to be the Packers leading 27 and the Dogs 7. It's about 2:04 left before the half. Let's hear another word from our sponsor. Virtual Attitude Wrestling is the number one virtual-based organization grid-wide, presenting 2 weekly shows. Elite Tuesday at 5 p.m. SLT and Turbulence Thursdays at 3 p.m. SLT. Be sure to come down with your family and friends and be a part of the magic of Second Life. Check out VAW website at vawuniverse.boards.net. Okay, Zaney's going to recover the ball. He's going to pick up about 18 yards. It's going to be Bulldogs going to take possession on their own 18. It's going to be 1st and 10 for them. And it's about 1:49 left in the half. And that's the 2-minute warning. Eric is going to be set up in the shotgun with no running back. He's going to have Holiday, Red Star, and Sky Tower off to his left. And to his right, he's got Lockwood and Quicksand to his right side as receivers. Let's see. It looks like they're going to pass it. And Eric is going to roll. And it's going to be a dead ball penalty. Might be an offensive call here. Let's see what the officials roll. It's going to be no cadence on the Bulls. On the Dogs. I'm sorry, guys. I keep calling them. So it's going to be 1st and 15 on the Bulldogs, roughly about 13 and a half yard line. All right, don't forget to stay with us as the cheerleaders from the Bulldogs and the Packers put on a show for you folks, so stay with us during the half. All right, Eric is going to set up again. He's going to have 3 receivers off to his right. His left, correction.
He does get that ball out.
Right.
It's going to be intercepted again by the Packers. Interception first.
Was it Holiday that intercepted it?
No, Holiday was the one who tackled.
Ah, okay.
It was Houseman.
Houseman intercepted the ball. I mean, Houseman's going to set up again with a lone receiver, Loon in the back, behind him. And let's see what the Packers can do at this point. They have about 1:42 left, so they may have enough time to score again. And it looks like Loon is going to take the ball and run it all the way in.
He did pass the ball, and it was incomplete. It will be 2nd and 10, and that will stop the clock.
I saw him light up in red, that's why. Sorry, folks. I saw him with a possession ball lit up in red. All right, so it's going to be 2nd and 10 on the Bulldogs 39. Again, Houseman's got Loon set up as a lone running back. And Houseman's going to roll it to the left, and he's looking.
It is going to be a deep pass to that open receiver, but it is going to be incomplete.
It's going to be an incomplete pass, yeah. It's going to be 3rd and 10 on the Bulldogs 39.
He did have that receiver open, but one of the Bulldogs, I think it was that left outside linebacker, he came straight in and almost tackled the quarterback, but one of his blockers did save him from being sacked. So I feel like he was a little bit nervous from that pressure, and that is what did have his accuracy off.
And Houseman's going to roll it to the left.
Another great penetration.
Blockers.
Oh, he stumbled and he is sacked.
Gets sacked behind the line. Loses about 5 yards on that play. So it's going to be 4th and 15 on the Bulldogs 44.
They are in field goal range.
See, Bert, now is the time that you go for it.
Oh, but they are in field goal range at the moment as well. You can't forget that.
I would just go for a first down. Let's see if I can get the first down on them now. Which is what it looked like they're setting up. Again, Houseman has Loon set up as a lone running back.
Packers will probably waste most of the clock here.
He's got Hastings out to the right, and Santana's going to be on the left side, wide receivers. Let's see, he's going to roll it to the
right. Dead ball penalty.
No cadence.
It will be on the Packers again.
That's going to be costly for them.
That guard keeps moving before. Well, that was no cadence. Never mind. My apologies.
That was a no cadence.
Yes.
Yeah. It's gonna be repeated.
That was almost a false start. That was almost a false start too. What I believe the no cadence takes precedence over false start.
Hey, all the Packers got to do is hold on to the ball for 36 seconds. That's all they need to do. To kill the clock.
But if they do not get the first down here, that will give the Bulldogs a small chance.
Give them a small chance, but if they can kill that clock down...
Well, they can't. It's
If they would kill the clock.
It's 4th down, so if they don't get the first down, it does become Bulldogs possession.
Uh-huh. I agree, but they can kill a lot of that time on there. See, because they're down to about 30 now.
That is going to be caught by Sifontis again, and he does score another touchdown for the Packers.
Yes, Santana scored on that one again. It's going to be his third touchdown of the evening. That was a great pass by Houseman. And Houseman's going to set up for the extra points. There's about 26 seconds left in the half. Don't forget to please stay with us as the cheerleading squads of both these teams perform for you. All right, Houseman kicks it. And the extra point's going to be good, so the Packers are going to lead 34 to the Dogs 7. About 24 seconds left on regulation time for halftime. Let's see if the Bulldogs can come back and answer the 7 points the Packers just put on the board. Lockwood is going to be deep and off to his right. He's going to have quicksand, and Eric is going to be off to his right side. go. They're going to kick the ball slightly off to the right, and Zaney's going to pick the ball up, and he's going to rip it. And he's going to run it up the right side. He gets stuck.
He does hand that ball off.
It off.
He does hand the ball off, and they do get to their 41-yard line. Great handoff. Great handoff.
Pick up about 28 yards. It's going to be first and 10 on the Dogs' 41-yard line. It's going to be about 8 seconds left in the half.
This is definitely going to be a pass play. Another deep ball. And let's see if the Bulldogs can take advantage.
Yeah, they're definitely going to throw it up in the air. I believe that. And down to about 4 seconds left on the clock. 3, 2.
Interception again. And that is the end of the half, ladies and gentlemen. We will have halftime.
Yeah, so the Packers are going to go in. Leading the game 34-7. And please stay with us for the show. We'll see you folks back here in about 20 minutes.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, please enjoy your halftime show. I will be your DJ again. I will get the music out here in just a second. Please be patient with me, but I will get this started soon. All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to your halftime show. We first do have the Augustus Bulldogs cheerleaders. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Please enjoy their dance and their cheer. right, ladies and gentlemen, now we will have the Ohana Packers cheerleaders, the Hotties, go with their dance and cheer. Hope you enjoy it. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen.
Get ready for the countdown. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Get ready for the countdown. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
Alright, ladies and gentlemen, that is your Ohana Hotties and also the Augustus Bulldogs cheerleaders. Hope you did enjoy their cheers and dances. Right, we will get back to the game here soon. Just give it a moment.
to the second half. Great job, ladies. Excellent show. Well, right now we have the Packers and the Dogs are taking the field at this point. And the Packers will be kicking it off to the left, from the left to the right to the Dogs. Okay, the Dogs are gonna have Lockwood deep. They're gonna have a quick sand off to the left, and Eric is gonna be off to Lockwood's right. In play now.
Alright, we should have this kickoff go any moment.
Alright, Zaney's gonna pick the ball up roughly at about their own 10. And he's gonna run it off to the right.
It is a fumble.
There
go. Oh, Packers player does pick it up, and he is going to run that in for a touchdown. Very costly turnover for the Bulldogs right there. Not a...
So the Packers are going to pull it out. They're going to score another 6 points. The Packers have been scoring, even though they do have more penalties than the Dogs, but they're capitalizing more.
All right, ladies and gentlemen.
Go ahead, I'm sorry.
Oh, I'm going to be right back. I need to take a quick moment. I did not get to take a moment during the halftime, but I will be right back.
Okay. Houseman setting up for the extra point for the Packers. Man, and the extra point is going to be good. So the Packers are going to lead 41 to the Dogs 7. I'm still 8:37. In the third quarter to play. Again, Lockwood's going to set up deep. He's going to have Quicksand off to his right, and Eric, Quicksand's going to be off to his left, and Eric's going to be off to his right. And the Packers set up to kick the ball again. They're going to kick it slightly off to the right side of the field, and Zaney's going to pick it up about 5 yards deep in his own end zone. He's going to bring it out to the right side, and he's going to cut back into the left, and he's going to go down at about 17. It's going to be a 22-yard pickup. It's going to be first and 10 on their own 17. All right, Eric is going to set up. He's got two running backs. He's got Red Star to the right of him, and Lockwood's going to be off to, Red Star is going to be in his left, and Lockwood's going to be off to his right. And he's going to hand it off to Zaney, who's going to run it to the left, and it's going to be a dead ball penalty. It's going to be a no cadence on the Bulls. The Bulldogs. I'm sorry, I keep calling the Bulls. It's the Bulldogs.
It's okay, Sean. It's okay.
I keep calling them the Bulls.
You should hear me. My second to last commentating, I kept calling the Bills the Cowboys. I know you play for the Bills, but I kept calling you guys the Cowboys.
That's okay. I was calling the Seahawks Seattle. All right, Eric is going to set up again. He's going to have Lockwood off to his right. And Red Star is going to be on his left. On the left. On the outside, he's got Durant, and he's got to his right, it's going to be Quicksand, and to his left is going to be Sky Tower on the inside, and Holiday is going to be on the outside there. Eric's going to take the ball, and he's going to roll it to the left, and it's going to be another dead ball. It seems like the Bulldogs are racking up these penalties now. It's going to be a false start. While they sort that out, let's hear a word from our sponsor. What Radio? What Radio? With four radio stations to choose from. Hip-hop, R&B, soul, island, reggae, calypso, and gospel.
What was that?
What radio?
What?
Alright, here we go. Eric sets up again. And he's gonna have Red Star off to his right, lone running back. And Sky Tower and Holiday are gonna be off to his left. And to his right is gonna be Lockwood's gonna be on the inside to his right, and Quicksand's gonna be to the outside. And he's gonna roll it to the left, and it looks like he's looking downfield.
Almost tackled for that safety. Interception again.
Intercepted by Eric, is it?
Yes. The Bulldogs.
It's intercepted by Eric.
The Bulldogs keep throwing those deep balls that keep getting intercepted. They need to start running shorter routes, or at least run the ball.
I said Eric, it was intercepted by Houseman. My fault.
It would be nice. The Bulldogs do need to change up their offense because their cornerbacks and safeties are just dropping back deep on each offensive try. I understand they are down by a lot of points, but you should try to bring in those safeties, at least the cornerbacks, to not go deep each play. Then that deep ball will open. But at that moment, that deep ball is not open. Intercepted by Holiday. The Bulldogs do grab the ball right back. They really do want their ball back that time. I would make a Bulldog joke, but I will hold my tongue.
Let's hope you didn't. The Bulldogs are going to take possession on their own 7-yard line.
It is going to be a run play.
It's
going
to run it out to the right. It's going to pick up about 4 yards. It's going to bring it out to their 11-yard line. So it's going to be 2nd and 6 for them. That's going to give them a little more breathing room to run. That should give Eric some space that he needed. They're going to set up with Sky Tower and Holiday to his left, and Lockwood and Quicksand is going to be out to his right. Red Star is going to be the lone running back just off to Eric's right. And the clock is ticking. We have about 7:21 left in the third quarter. He's going to take it. He's going to drop straight back. He's going to roll to the right. He's being chased.
He's going to pass that, and it is going to be incomplete.
Incomplete. It's going to be an incomplete pass. It's going to be 3rd and 6 on their own 11. It looks like he threw it short to his receiver. To the left, and he cuts back to the right. He's being chased by a couple of backers, and it looks like he stepped out of bounds. No, it was an incomplete pass. I'm sorry. It looked like he stepped
out
of bounds.
Yes, it did. It was very close. It is a good thing he did get that ball out, or it would have been a safety.
Yeah, it's going to be 4th and 6 on their 11. Let's see if the Dogs may be punting it. And yes, they will be punting. And deep for the Packers to receive the ball will be Houseman. Houseman's he's set up at about his own 40, 35-yard line, roughly. And the ball is kicked down the right side of the field. It's going to get past Houseman. Is it going to roll out before it gets to the end zone? No, Houseman.
No, he is going to pick that up.
Yeah, he's going to pick it up at about the 13-yard line. And he's going to run it back
for 27 yards.
So it's going to be a pickup of 27 yards. It's going to be 1st and 10 on the Packers' 41-yard line. Again, Eric is setting up with the lone running back. Loon's going to be right behind him setting up.
It is a dead ball penalty. I believe it is going to... Yes, it is. It's going to be a
false start. Yeah. First down will be repeated. And it's going to be a 5-yard penalty on the Packers. You know, for the number of penalties they've gotten the Packers, it still doesn't... They're still putting points on the board. I'm trying to figure out how they manage that one.
But we will see how the Packers handle this one. It will be quite entertaining to see how this turns out for them. And there goes the ball. It is going to be intercepted by two Zaney for you. Zaney intercepted that ball. The Packers were doing very well on their passing game, but they're both both plays have been pass plays, and they both have been intercepted. So it looks like the Bulldogs secondary has.
It looks like the ball is just going back and forth. It's
yes.
Each team is turning it over. Right, Eric is going to set up. He's going to have Red Star lined up as the lone running back behind him.
Yes.
He's going to have Lockwood and Quicksand off to his right, and his left is going to be Holiday.
Well, before the half started, the Packers, the Bulldogs secondary wasn't playing very well, so I think the Packers wanted to come out here for the second half and take advantage of it. But it seems like the Bulldogs have picked up their defensive play and stopped that long deep ball that the Packers have had all night. But ooh, he does get sacked.
Eric is going to get tackled. He's going to lose about 15 yards.
Yep.
21st and 20, second and 25 yep. On the Dogs, 24.
Kawana Wantabe had that. The actual owner of the Packers had that great blitz and that great sack. Very nice job by her to stop that play. Because he did have a few receivers open, but she sacked him. And great defensive play from Kawana from the Packers.
Eric is going to take the snap. He's going to roll it left and right. And now he's going to cut up the middle. He throws it up the middle.
Incomplete pass.
Incomplete pass. So it's going to be 3rd and 25 on their own 24-yard line.
He did do a great job stopping those. He did do a great job stopping those, missing those tackles, because he did juke his way out of another sack.
Again, Eric sets up with Red Star lined up behind him. It's about 5:55 left in the third. All right, Eric is going to roll to the left.
He is going to pass that ball across field.
Across the field.
And it is going to be
too
Zaney. Does
32 yards on the play.
Very nice catch by Zaney. He was in coverage there. Very nice job.
Yeah, it's gonna be 1st and 10 on the Packers 44 now. Again, Eric is gonna set up with Red Star behind him. And he's got, to his left, he's got Holiday in the outside in Sky Tower, just inside of him. And to the right, he's going to have Quicksand. And Lockwood's going to play tight end just off the right side of the line there.
They are using the pistol formation. It almost looked like it was going to be a handoff to Red. It almost looks like they're trying to try a... yes.
That pass is thrown out of bounds. It's going to be 2nd and 10 on the, correction, it's going to be on the Bulldogs 44. I thought it was on the Packers 44.
It is on the Packers 44.
It is on the Packers 44, I was right.
But we...
I'm seeing double sets of lines, that's why.
Yes. he does hike the ball off. He does toss it up, and it is going to be intercepted by the Packers again. So it'll be 1st and 10 on the Bulldogs' 24-yard line. A great offensive drive from the Bulldogs, but sadly it did not turn into points. It was another turnover. But let's see if the Bulldogs can get the ball back.
And that's going to be Durante with the interception on that play. So it's going to be first and 10 on the Packers. It looks like it's a 24, I think. And Houseman's going to have Loon set up.
Great sack. Great sack by Cheese. Cheese broke through that line and said, "Look, give me your quarterback. I'm not giving up on this game." Great play from Cheese Quicksand to come and sack that Packers quarterback. He got straight through that line and just came right at him.
It's going to be a loss of 7 yards. It's going to be second and 17 on the Packers' 17-yard line. And Houseman this time has Loon set off to his right, and Devontae's going to be off to his left.
He does hike the ball, but it is going to be a dead ball penalty. I believe it will be another false start. Oh, nope, Cadence from the Packers. They really need to fix this issue. That is the fifth no Cadence tonight on the Packers.
Yeah, but it doesn't really matter the number of penalties they're getting, because it really doesn't reflect on their scoring.
I wouldn't want penalties.
I'm trying to figure out how they're managing that.
Even if I'm winning the game, I wouldn't want penalties in the first place. I agree.
I mean, that's ideal overall, but the Packers, I mean, where are they up to, like, to the 9th, 10th penalty? But if you look at the score, it doesn't look like they have any penalties at all. Houseman's going to set up again. He's got Loon off to his right. Devanter's going to be off to his left. And he's going to roll to the right. It looks like he's looking downfield.
He does throw
and
that ball.
Across.
It is going to be incomplete pass.
So it's going to be 3rd and 22 on their own 12.
Right now, all the Packers need to do is just kill the time. That's all they need to do.
Oh, they should be running the ball.
All they need to do is time management at this point. Because there's about 4 minutes, a little less than 4 minutes left in the third quarter, so.
Another dead ball penalty, which will bring it to third and 30, I believe.
It's going to be a full start on them.
Yes, it will be 3rd and 27.
Give or take a yard or two.
It will be, 3rd and 27. Repeat 3rd down. And that is another false start. But the issue is, I understand that the Packers really don't need to be worrying about penalties, but they do have the lead. But for future games, they really do need to fix this issue. Because if they are in a really tight game, being 3rd and 27, if you're down a touchdown or tied, you do not want that. They've lost 10 yards just from penalties alone on this possession.
Yeah, they have, yeah. Let's see if they can get themselves out of this jam.
Cheese almost blitz him again. He does get stumbled in the end zone. He is going to break free and does toss it right at that line of scrimmage. Cifontis does catch it. Great play from that Packers quarterback.
Jersey, it's going to be a 37-yard pickup. It's going to be 1st and 10 on the
great
on their own 45. So the Packers did dig themselves out of that hole.
Great play from that.
This is what I'm saying. It doesn't matter the number of penalties for them, because it doesn't reflect what's happening.
Oh yeah, I understand that, but when it comes to but you want to start working on that now, because you don't want to keep getting these penalties, because if next game if you come out and do the same thing, the score might not be the same.
Oh, I agree. But right now they just like I said, all the Packers have to do at this point is just kill the clock. They're down to about less than 3.5 minutes in the third quarter, and they got 9 minutes to play. So you figure they got about 12 minutes left, 12 and a half minutes left to play in the entire game. I would just kill the clock at this point. And just watch the turnovers. Make sure that they don't turn it over to the Bulldogs. I mean, Haskins going to set up with Loon off to the right, and Devontae's going to be off to his left. He's going to have, to his left, he's got Durant and Santana off to his left. On his right, he's going to have Hastings as a wide receiver.
But that was a great play from that Packers quarterback. He was almost sacked for a safety, but he got away from it.
Again, Houseman looks like he's going to get the first down. He's going to get close to a first down. He's going to pick up about 8 yards on that one. So it's going to be second and two on the Dogs 47. I'm saying, and this is what you want. You want that clock to keep ticking on you, which is what the Packers are doing. See, all they have to do is just watch that ball clock and wait till it gets down to about 10 seconds before they hike it. Now, they'll be in good, because there's less than 3 minutes.
Looks like the Bulldogs have lost 3 players from the start of this game. They did have 11, but now they are down to 8, which is not a good thing being down like this. He is going to run the ball. Nope, he throws it deep down. It is going to be received by that Packers player.
Devontae catches the ball and picks up about 34 yards.
Another 34 yards.
Yeah, it's going to be first and 10 on the Dogs 13. That was a great pass. That was a great pass. Great catch by Devontae.
Well, when you're not being pressured too well and your players are open, you know, you're going to make great plays like that.
Mm-hmm. Oh, absolutely. And Houseman's going to have Loon as the lone running back behind him.
It looks like they're killing the clock. Here we go.
He is going to be stopped for a gain of 3 yards. Stopped by two Zaney for you. Great job from Zaney from that safety spot to notice that run and come and stop it. But currently, folks...
It's going to be second and 7 for them.
Currently, folks, it is 41-7. Packers winning with a minute and 20 seconds left of the third quarter. So we still do have a full other quarter to play still. Let's see if the Packers can rack up more points for the whole playoff point system thing. And I think that's what the Packers are doing. They could be wasting the clock, but with no mercy rule ticking, they do want those points for the end of the season. And they do score a touchdown there.
Santana scores, 10-yard touchdown pass. Packers are going to take the lead. It's going to be 47 to the Dogs, 7. Now it's an excellent play by Houseman. Man, Houseman's going to set up for the extra point.
All right, that is going to be no good.
No good.
That was
the second time that he's missed it.
That was kicked at 15%, which is very odd to see.
That's the second miss of the evening. A quick word from our sponsor. Come to the next game in style. Devalicious Designs has a vast selection of stunning clothing, skins, and hair for the ladies to get you looking your best. Don't forget you guys. They have another shop for clothing devoted to the latest in men's fashion. Stop by and visit them today. But yeah, that was an excellent play. That was an excellent play by Houseman. And it looks
Tuzani does catch it, but he does not. He does not wait for his blockers again. And just runs it straight from the out of the end zone to the 25. And that's one thing.
Looks like he handed it off to Holiday, and Holiday picked up an additional couple of yards. It's going to be a total gain of 27. So it's going to be the Dogs going to take possession on their own 25. It's going to be first and 10 for them. And the clock has stopped for 45 seconds left in the third quarter. Let's see, it looks like a couple players running off to the sideline. They may be bringing someone in. But while they do that, we'll have another word from our sponsor. Combatant is the first and still the lead innovator in high-quality, 100% original mesh and clothing products aimed for the football community with an SL. They offer a wide range of products from cleats, helmets, compression clothing, uniforms, hand warmers, gloves, and much more. Don't accept cheap imitations. Determine the game, not the game determine you.
All right, looks like the Bulldogs.
I think they brought in another player.
Yes, they wanted to make sure they had 9 players on the field.
It looks like Zaney is quarterbacking this time.
The Bulldogs like to do that. If you scrim against the Bulldogs or if you've played against them before, Zaney and Sayre Nubala, they will change out of quarterbacks. Zaney is more of a type of Michael Vick quarterback. He will look for the run first before he throws. But then Sayre is different. Sayre would rather throw it than run the ball. So it's more or less it's just what kind of offense they want to be run at the moment. It looks like this is going to be a pass play. It was a short pass that was right behind his receiver, though, sadly. It was a good throw. His receiver did just not adjust on the ball to make that catch.
It can be 2nd and 10 on their own 25. About 37 seconds left on the third quarter. Lockwood's going to roll to the right. Looks like he's going to go for it.
And he does pick up the first down.
He picks up about 7.
Makes it 3rd and 3, but that is the danger of Zaney as the quarterback. He will either, if he wants to go for the run, he will just start off that run. He will not wait. And the Packers eventually stopped it, but I don't think they saw that Zaney was just going to run straight out towards that right side, so it's a great decision by Zaney because it does bring them within 3 yards of a first down.
And that's going to end the third quarter. It's going to be the start of the fourth quarter now.
Looks like Zaney is going to pass the ball. He passes the ball to Holiday, who's open, but Holiday does not catch the ball, sadly. Holiday was open there. Close play by the Bulldogs. If Holiday did catch that ball, he would have been open for a touchdown. But it looks like the Bulldogs are going to punt it. 3rd and 3. They are down 5 touchdowns. I'm very shocked. 2-3 on 4th and 3 at the moment for the Bulldogs to bring out the punt formation. I would have thought with how far they're down, they would have at least tried to gain those 3 yards for that first down. But it looks like it's going to be a fake. He does punt it away. Looks like Zaney was going to try and fake
and
the punt.
Houseman's
going to
pick it up and run it back. He's going to pick up about 16 yards. So it's going to be 1st and 10 on the Packers 32. Yeah, he just ran off to the left. I thought he was going to run completely.
I honestly believe he was going to try and fake. But when he noticed those Packers players were right there, I think he decided he could still kick the ball. And that's what he decided to do, which is a smart play by Zaney to at least try and see if he can get the first down before he does kick the ball away. But sadly, the Packers saw through it and stopped Zaney. I give him credit for at least trying to see if he can get the first down before he does kick it away.
Harris sets up, and he's got Lopez and set up as a lone running back behind him. And it's going to be a delay of game? No? Maybe? No. Hossman's going to snap. He's going to roll it to the left. And he's looking downfield. And
he does chuck that ball. Incomplete pass.
It's going to be an incomplete pass, yeah. It's going to be 2nd and 10.
Very deep pass. with what I'm noticing from the Packers at the moment, their quarterback does not like to throw it across field, so if he is to the left or right, that is where he is going to throw the ball. And I do hope the Bulldogs realize that if he does go to the left or right when that play starts, to notice that and focus that side of the field with their secondary. But we will see if they pick that up. I know it's kind of late in the game, but there still is a chance. There's always a chance to come back. That's the wonder of football. You never know what is going to happen. Nothing is absolute.
I agree.
But that pass is going to be incomplete, and that actually wasn't a crossfield pass, which is what I said earlier, that it was very interesting too. It was very interesting too. It's almost like it's almost like he's listening to me or something.
Like, well, wait a second, he just went to this whole thing and now he's doing a crossfield. Yeah, he's gonna set up again. He's got Lopez in the backfield. And he's gonna roll to the left.
Flag on the play, dead ball penalty.
Flag on the play.
This one is from, yep, that one is from cocaine. But this no cadence, these Packers need to fix this no cadence issue. That is the 7th or 8th one, I believe, tonight they've been called on.
Houseman's going to set up again. He's going to set up with a two tight ends on the front line. And he's got Lopez set up behind him. And he's going to roll to the left.
Dead ball penalty again.
Dead ball penalty.
Let's see what it is this time. It looks like Flo caught this one. Let's see what Flo says on this one. It is going to be a false start.
Offside.
So about each offensive drive the Packers have done, they've had a false start and no cadence each time they get the ball. Which I understand they are up by 5 touchdowns, as we talked about earlier. But when it comes to a crucial game, if they were only up by 3 points or if they were down by a touchdown, these penalties would be a lot more costly than they are right now. So let's hope the Packers fix their no cadence and false start issues before their next game, or it's not going to look very well for them.
He's going to take it. He's going to roll to the right, and he's going to throw across the field. And it looks like it's going to be caught.
But he is going to be tackled by Holiday. It was a 60.
61 yards. It was a. Whether he tackles him. It's picked up 61 yards on that play. It's going to be 1st and 10 on the Bulls' 17-yard line, and Durante. With a great pass. And they're going to threaten to score again. And here comes Houseman. He's going to roll to the right.
And he
looks
does.
Like he tries to kind of, yeah, he picks about 2 on that one.
Great play from Jordan Holiday to come back and stop that run play. Good job of him
so
to notice.
2nd and 8 on the Dogs' 16-yard line. About 7:09 left, 7:08 left in the game. Go Houseman sets up. He's got Lopez in the backfield with him. And oh, he gets
going to be sacked.
5 yards on that play. He gets sacked by Sky Tower there.
A great play.
3rd and 13.
Great stoppage.
Dogs 21. That was an excellent play. Sky Tower
got in there to get him.
It is going to be a pass play. That player does catch the ball, and he is going to score a touchdown.
Yeah.
So
it's a touchdown, 21-yard pass to Devontae.
If they,
that's going to make it 53 and the dog 7.
If the Packers score another touchdown, that I believe that mercy rule. No, the mercy rule will be 54-7. The point difference will be 54 points.
It's got
to
be 55 points.
So if they do score another touchdown, we will not activate the mercy rule because they will be 1 point shy.
It'll put them close.
It'll be at, yep.
The extra point is good. Yeah, I was doing the arithmetic. Yeah, 7 points will give them 61.
Then 61 minus 7.
62, yeah. You see, if they would have scored those two...
extra points from earlier.
Those two extra points, yeah, it would have gone into effect. So, yeah. Alright, the dogs have zany deep to recover. It looks like it's being kicked off to the...
it is going to be a touchback.
Left side, and it's
going
to roll out into the end zone. It's going to be first and 10 on the dog's 20. There's about 6:03 left in the game. And Zany Lockwood is going to be quarterbacking now. He's got Red Star off to his right, and he's got Mondavi off to his left. And he's going to, Lockwood's going to roll it to the left. And
he does break.
In and out for a first down. Looks like he's picked up enough for a first down. So actually, it's going to be second and inches. I thought he picked that up. It's going to be second and inches on their own 30.
Great play from Zany. He did not get that first down, but he is right there. That ball is right on that line.
Yeah, it's just inches. Yeah, I thought he crossed. I thought he broke the plane, but I guess he didn't.
Happens a lot in the CFL. You think you have that first down. Ooh, great handoff to Rhino Red Star. The Packers did not see that handoff coming. He ran straight up the middle, picked up 8 yards. I didn't even see that coming until that position circle change. Great decision from the Bulldogs. This is what I like to see, is they are changing the game up from those deep passes to runs, short passes. They're changing up their offense with Zany as their quarterback, and
yeah, what's happening is the Bulldogs are allowing the clock to tick on them. They need to stop this clock.
I think the issue.
Each time they get tackled on the field, that clock keeps ticking on them. So the Bulldogs, really, that clock is their enemy at this point. Even though they're making excellent yardage, don't get me wrong, but the clock is ticking on
them.
They need to stop that clock, is what they need to do.
The problem, though, is that the Bulldogs did long passes so much the second and third quarter, the Packers are going off of it, and they're dropping back almost everybody for coverage play. So if they do want to open up the deep passes, they do have to bring in a few players to come in blitz to open their receivers. That's the issue with... They can do the deep passes, but as you saw most of the game, they were intercepted.
And a quick word from our sponsor. Tired of trying to fit yourself into fashion category that just doesn't seem to fit you? It's too mainstream, too blah, or just generally too conformative? Scene is the brand that is going to change all that. Thinking outside the box, pushing the boundaries of style and fashion. They are there to help you explore your personality and mold your SL to fit your style. With a little bit of everything, they can guarantee you will find something that works for you. That sounds like a place I need to check out.
Very interesting store. Very good. He actually just redesign his whole store about a week ago, I believe.
Uh-huh.
Zany does get that ball out to Jay Holiday, and as you saw, the Packers only had about 4 people out there in coverage, and they blitzed 5. So that did open the pass game for the Bulldogs. I think the Bulldogs, No, they can't win this game, but I think they just want to get more points on the board before this game ends.
Oh, they'll probably score another 7, but that clock is there. They're not managing that clock.
It is going to be a... Let's see if Zaney will break the line. Makes great room with that run. He picks up about 13 yards. Great decision by Zaney to just take that ball and run it with most of his players in coverage to pick up that first down and get closer to that end zone.
It'll be first and 10 on the Packers 34.
Zaney is going to run it again, and it's going to be Cheese Quicksand, a handoff to Zaney. Cheese does pick up 4 yards. We have about 2 minutes and 45 seconds left on the clock of this fourth quarter. I believe the Bulldogs just want to put more points on the board before this game ends, and does not want the Packers to have the ball again to put more hurt on them. Well, we are going to see Zaney go out. Holiday was open, but he was covered quickly. It is another throw to Holiday. It is going to be over his head in an incomplete pass, which will bring 3rd and 6 of the Bulldogs. Zaney does hike the ball. He moves out to the left. He does pass it. It is caught from Cheese. Cheese gets to the 2-yard line. Great catch from Cheese. He had a lot of white around him, but Cheese said, "That is my ball. Thank you very much, Packers. That is mine, though." And he does make it to that 2-yard line. And that is the 2-minute warning. Great play from Cheese Quicksand. Very nice shot.
That was a great play.
To Zaney, looks like he's going to run it, and he is going to get right at that goal line. Nope, he gains no yards. Very nice try from Zaney. Second. He almost made it.
That was a nice play by the Packers. They pursued him well on that one.
Let's see what the Packers, Bulldogs, decide to do here. This close to their red zone. This is the only time they've been in their red zone. Let's see if Zaney is going to hand it off to Holiday. Holiday is going to run. I believe that is a touch. Nope, that is right at the... That is... He is a half a yard away from the...
6 inches.
Yes. He is a half a yard away. Which we will see. Yep, I know exactly what Zaney wants to do here. It is very smart by Zaney. Let's see if it does work for them. He will need that guard to get in his position, though, before he hikes the ball. Let's see what Zaney does here. But I have a feeling I know exactly what Zaney is going to do here. He should hike this. He is going to hike it. It is going to be a touchdown. He does cross... I hope they review that play, because he was tackled.
Says no gain on the play.
He was tackled past that line.
Dogs are wasting way too much time.
They need to call a timeout. They need to call a timeout here. They do have timeouts available. I don't know why they're not calling a timeout. Let's hope those players get lined up before... He does have 20 seconds left. Let's hope he gets his center in place. I'm pretty sure Zaney's screaming at him, "Can you please get on your prims?" He has 10 seconds left. I don't know what that player is doing who's just standing there. They are going to call a timeout, but it seems like the player Lawn was taking his time to get on his prim. I don't know if there was an issue with him touching his prim, but they wasted about 28 seconds there just to get that timeout out. Which, I know Zaney wanted to rush that ball out, but it was not very... Something was not right there, but at least they do have the timeout and they do call it. It will be 4th and 1 with half a yard to go. But they are going to bring back out the power with Zaney right underneath the center. But I believe the Packers, if the Packers are smart, they will put 6 people on their prims and take those cornerbacks and safeties off their prims and just put them straight in the middle. Because as the rule is, you only need 6 people on your prims on defense. But it looks like the Packers aren't going to do it. And the ball is in play. He does get it. I believe that is a touchdown. That is not a touchdown.
It's stopped again. It's turned over on downs. It's going to be the Packers.
That is going to be the end of the game. I believe that is a touchdown. Yeah. That ball, I would review that, but that is, I believe the game is over.
It's going to be the Packers. Packers are going to win this 54 to the Bulldogs 7. Great game to both teams. You guys did excellent. And, also, kudos to their cheerleading squad. Those ladies did a great job for us. I want to thank everybody for coming out. And, Bert, thank you. It's been my pleasure.
You're welcome, Sean. It's been a great game. Hope you enjoyed.
Are they recalling it, Wade? Are they recalling it?
I think they are, because the players are not off the field.
Yeah, I was just going to say that.
The refs are...
I think the Bulldogs are arguing that one.
I think they are. The Bulldogs might be arguing it. Players have not left the field. The refs have not left the field. So, ladies and gentlemen, if you are still here, this game is not over. Nope, it looks like it is. All the Bulldogs are leaving.
It's officially over now. I think they argued it, and I think it was futile. All right, I want to thank everybody for coming tonight. I'm Sean Richards, and thank you, Bert, again. Everyone, have a wonderful evening.
That ball has broken the pylon, if you do look at it. But you all have a great, I have the film of it. I'm on the ball right now, and if you do look at the ball has broken the pylon. It has broken the plane of field. But the game is over. Good game, everybody. Hope you enjoyed. Have a good night, Sean.
Have a great evening.